for some of our leaders that we are mentoring to come through to SAFM. And I mean, just to give you also just a bit of what will be happening at the summit, we will have panel discussions which we actually put together our leaders together with the, you know, the industry leaders. For instance, you've got the likes of Ezra Ngandwe, the founder of you know, Youth Empowerment Fund. You've got the likes of DJ Sbu. You know, you've got the likes of Candace Ofuku, the president of Abasa. They will be in panel discussions discussing topical issues together with the leaders that we are actually mentoring at our partner school. So that should be very exciting, and I look forward to, you know, having our learners on SAFM to share their experiences and their stories about what youth managers have actually brought in their personal lives and at schools. Yes.
Well, I feel sorry for the panelists, because I know if you've got a group of young leaders that are thinkers and are action-orientated, panel discussions are quite difficult for the panelists because they ask very difficult questions. Mabuto, thank you so much for joining the chairman of the Youth Managers Foundation. I'm also joined now on the line. Now, just a story before I tell you about this next guest. Is sometimes when you have an impact on people's lives, you don't realize how far that goes and the trickle effect of it. Now, on the line is Dr. David Harrison. He's the CEO of the DG Murray Trust. They fund the Nali Bali campaign, but DG Murray Trust also funds an organization, a youth leadership organization called Activate, and I am a product of Activate way before I even came on to SAFM, and now I'm here because I learned how to put things into action. Dr. Harrison, thank you so much for joining us.
Saladi, it's David, and it's a pleasure to be with you on the program, and I'm delighted that you're a product of Activate.
I really am glad to finally speak to you. So I know we're talking specifically about the Nali Bali campaign. Tell us about it. What exactly? I think we've heard about it a whole lot, and it's obviously encouraging a culture of reading in South Africa. But let's talk about the impact you've had and the projects that you're running at the moment.
Yeah, Nali Bali's been going for about 2.5 years now, and basically it's trying to get South Africans to understand the incredible power that they have through storytelling and reading. And what people don't realize is that just telling children stories, just reading to them, and reading to yourself if you're a teenager, improves your language development hugely. You know, we tend to think that the time for us to start reading is when we go to school. But in fact, the real development of the brain, the circuitry of the brain that is that needs to be laid down for mathematics, for literature development, for literacy, for numeracy, that actually happens from birth. It happens in the first 4 or 5 years of life. And so that circuitry that is being laid down, call it the broadband if you like, really depends on people talking to their children, telling them stories, reading to them, showing them pictures, stimulating their imagination.
Right.
And there's huge, huge power in that. And so what Nali Bali tries to do through billboards, through radio programs, through a lot of books, and through community radio, community clubs, reading clubs across the country, is try and stimulate this excitement, this desire to read.
And just, you know, one of the things I've always said is that, you know, you compare two South African children, one that at the age of 3, I've seen families do this all the time, you say, Jaiva Nana, and the baby dances, and that's all the child is taught, and then you read to the child every night. If you have a separate child that is read to every night, you've taught the child to be interested in knowledge, to be keen to acquire knowledge, David.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, and actually what happens in South Africa is that poorer kids tend to be on the lower trajectory of life. They simply can't, they can't develop as much because they just don't have the opportunity of the wealthy kids. But the one thing that all of us have in our hands is the ability to talk with our children. So even money poor families can be language rich. And if you can really start engaging with your children, we call it serve and return. You tell them something, they burble back at you, you get them interested. If you can do that, even kids from poor families can end up on that higher trajectory of life.
Absolutely. Dr. David Harrison, that's where we'll have to close it off, but I know we'll be chatting to you again soon, I hope. CEO of the DG Murray Trust, or the DG Murray Trust rather, and they fund the Nali Bali campaign. So this week we saw, I think it was World Hunger Day, and, you know, a lot of conversations about South Africans themselves.